Vishnupad, Paramahamsa Paribrajakacharya Astatara Satashishumat, Abhay Charanarvinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki, Iskan Bhivri Founder Acharya Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada Ki, Anantakati Vaishnavrinda Ki, Namacharya Srila Haridas Thakur Ki, Prem Se Kaho Se Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Adaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki, Sri Radha Krishna Gop Gopinath Swayam Kunda Radha Kunda Griga Badhan Ki, ब्रजमय वृंदावन धाम की नवदेव मायापुर धाम की गंगा माई जमुना माई की श्रीमती भक्ति देवी की श्रीमती तुलसी महारानी की हरिनाम संकीर्तन की निताई गौर प्रेमानंद ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबली बॉडीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबली बॉडीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबली बॉडीज ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू गुरु एंड गौरांगा ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्रील प्रभुपाद ओम अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य Gyananjana Salakaya Shakshu Sunmilitang Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manabhishtam Sthapitang Jena Bhutale Shayang Rupa Kadamaiham Dadati Sha Padantikam Bandeham Sri Gura Sri Juta Padakamalang Sri Gurung Vaishnavangsya Sri Rupang Chagra Jatang Sahagana Raghunathanitang Tang Sajivam Sadaitang Sabadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakhanitangsya Namong Vishnu Padaya Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschata Desatarine Vancha Kalpata Rubhasya Kripa Sindhu Bhaivacha Patitanang Pavanebho Vaishnavebho Namo Namaha Namo Mahavadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratishche Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaurabhakta Vinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Mukham Kurati Bachalam, Pangulang Haitagirin, Yat Kripata Mahambande, Sri Guru Dinatarinam, Paramananda Madhavam, Sri Chaitanya Isharam. Hare Krishna. So, I'd like to welcome all of you for the Sunday morning program, Sunday feast program. At ISKCON Whitefield. Although I come to Bangalore regularly for many years, somehow or other I missed the opportunity to come here, but this time by the arrangement of Gandharvika Giridhari and Sriman Mahaprabhu, so I am able to be here on this Sunday morning program. So, this month is also a very special month for ISKCON devotees. This is December month. It's a month of preaching. And Prabhupada used to say preaching means book distribution. So, we'll try to discuss something about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's preaching activities. And Srila Prabhupada's preaching activity and our preaching activity. So today's topic and discussion will be only preaching. So you are okay with that? Okay. So Mahaprabhu has set a standard. He predicted that Prithivite Achajata Nagaradi Gram Sarvatra Pacharita Hoibe Mor Naam. What a vision he gave. In every town and village, all over the world, the holy name will spread. Who predicted that? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You know that, right? How many of you know this? Please raise your hand. Just checking. Mahaprabhu predicted it, but Mahaprabhu did not do it. He only preached inside India. Right, Mahaprabhu? And especially he preached in South India. His first preaching tour was South India. You are very fortunate because you are from that land. You are happy to be South Indians? Very good. Some are not so happy because they are maybe in South India, but they are not from South India. So, he did not do that. He did not preach Krishna consciousness out of India. Why? Because that time there was no flight. How he'll go? Flight facilities were not there. Very difficult to cross the ocean. But reason why Mahaprabhu did not do that, because that is the nature of the Lord. Lord always wants to give the credit to his devotee. That is the nature of the Lord. And devotees, they want to give the credit to Lord. Competition. Competition of giving credit. But in this world, there is a competition also of taking credit. So, if anything good is done, who has done it? I have done it. If anything wrong has happened, who has done it? He has done it. So we don't want to take the blame, but we want to take the credit. That is the nature of this material world. But in the spiritual world, it is completely opposite. So naturally, the Lord wants to give the credit of this mission to his dear devotee. And Srila Prabhupada, His Divine Grace, Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, was chosen as Senapati Bhakta, the Commander-in-Chief of the Sankirtan movement, to take this message all over the world. So I want to discuss the mood of a preacher first, because that is very, very important. If mood is right, everything is right. But if the mood is wrong, things will be not so nice. So Mahaprabhu, he appeared on this planet to establish Sankirtan movement, chanting of the holy name of the Lord. That's why he appeared. And through holy name, he wanted to spread the message of love of Godhead, which has not been done for a long, long time. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami explains, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, anarpita charing chirat korunaya avatirna kalau samarpayitim unnata ujjala rasang savakti shriyam hari purata sundara duti kadamba sandipita sada hidaya kandare spuratuba sachinandana. So Mahaprabhu appeared to spread the message of love of Godhead to everyone. But he appeared in Mayapur, Navadvip Dham. But he was not preaching Krishna consciousness. He was waiting for so many years. So when he went to Gaya to do the sadhya ceremony of his father, and at Gaya he was initiated by his spiritual master, Ishvara Puripad. And after initiation, he became mad in ecstasy of love of Godhead. And he was running towards Vrindavan. Mad in ecstasy of love of Godhead, he was running towards Vrindavan. That is the effect of initiation. That is the meaning of initiation. Initiation means changing the heart. That is the meaning of initiation. Initiation means transformation within. That is the meaning of initiation. But we are very happy to change our name. We also change our life by changing our name. Our name is changed, so we got initiated. We change our dress, we change our hairstyle, we change our other style of life. But the everything is changed, but if the heart is not changed, then that is not the real initiation. So Mahaprabhu is exhibiting the real meaning of initiation. His heart was transformed. He was experiencing love of Godhead, mad in ecstasy of love of Godhead, and he was running towards Vrindavan. But that time there was a message from the sky. And the message was, now is not the time to go to Vrindavan. And he was reminded that you have appeared to establish Sankirtan movement. So now you don't go to Vrindavan, you go to Navadip and start the congregational chanting of the holy name of the Lord. So then Mahaprabhu came back to Navadip. Then he started the Sankirtan movement. Although he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, although he is the father of the Sankirtan movement, but he started his service only when he was ordered to do so. That should be the mood of a preacher. We should be always under the guidance of our spiritual authorities. If that is not there, there is no question of preaching. So preaching means accepting someone as our spiritual authority. Without that, preaching will not have any significant impact in our life or in the lives of others. So what is the mood of a preacher? Mood of a preacher should be accepting somebody in our life. So acceptance of authority is the very important aspect of our spiritual journey, and that also involves our service as a preacher. So you may say, no, already Mahaprabhu said, Bharat Bhumite Manusya Janma Hoilo Jar, Janma Sarthakari Karo Paroupakar, Jare Dekho Tare Kaho Krishna Padesh, Amaragyai Guru Hoya, Taroi Desh. Already Mahaprabhu has ordered. So is the need of any other person in between of obstacle on the path of my preaching? That is not the mood. Mood is, we should accept the position of the servant, of the servant, of the servant, of the servant, of the servant. That is the mood. Mahaprabhu imbibed and Mahaprabhu wanted us to also imbibe. The mood of humility. If that is not there, there is no question of devotional service. So humility is a fundamental quality we should cultivate in our character to be a devotee. So Mahaprabhu already showed us, and Mahaprabhu already taught us. Now our constitutional position is Gopi Bhartu Padakamalayor Das Dasanu Das. The servant of the servant, not only the servant. Servant of the servant, of the servant, of the servant, of the servant, of the servant. Of the servant, continues, of the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, who is the master of the gopis. So our life will be successful when the number of devotees between me and Krishna is many. As many numbers are there, that will be the secret of our success in our spiritual journey. So spiritual life means to learn how to become humble, small. So when we become small, smaller and the smallest, more we get success in our spiritual life. That is the secret. But here, In this world, we want to become great, greater, greatest. So Prabhupada has introduced a system. When we get initiated, we change our name. Guru changes our name, right? Prabhupada introduced that. And Prabhupada used to give initiation. One devotee came to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, you initiated me. I got a name, but I forgot the name. So it was Samsundar or something, I cannot remember. Can you tell me? So Prabhupada said, that is not the important part of the name. Second part you remember, no? Das. That is the important part. Please remember that, that is enough. Whether it is Samsundar or Jagannath or Giridhari, or that's not so important. What is important? Das. But we want to forget that. Because we want to forget our real constitutional position, because that is our nature. So therefore, Prabhupada has introduced such a system by name itself. It reminds us that who we are. But Maya is very strong. Because I may be Das, but Prabhupada has introduced the system that we should address other devotees as Prabhu. To keep us humble, no? So now, although I am Das, devotees are addressing me as Prabhu. Hare Krishna Prabhu, how are you Prabhu, what can I do you Prabhu? So if you hear the same thing again and again, the conditioned soul has a nature to believe it. So I am hearing again and again, Prabhu, Prabhu, Prabhu. Then we start thinking, maybe I have been now elevated from Das to Prabhu. So we start believing that I am no more Das anymore. I am Prabhu. So he called Hare Krishna. So who is speaking? Samsundar Prabhu speaking. So from Das to Prabhu. So we have advanced in Krishna consciousness because we have changed our position from Das to Prabhu. Then in ISKCON, everything is Maha. Mahaprasad, Maha Harinam, Maha Big Book. Everything is Maha. So people don't get satisfaction only becoming Prabhu. Because life gets perfected when Maha is added in our life. So we get perfection by becoming Mahaprabhu. Then it's okay. That is called Ishvara Bhav. Very strongly inbuilt in our system. Although Prabhupada has given a system to become Das Das Anudas, but we become Das to Prabhu to Mahaprabhu. So that's why very difficult to become humble. Very difficult. So what is the symptom of advancement? Prabhupada is speaking in Krishna book and other places also. That who is a Kanishtha Adhikari Bhakta devotee, who is a Madhyama Adhikari devotee, and who is a Uttama Adhikari devotee. Very nicely explained by Prabhupada. A Kanishtha Adhikari Bhakta or Kanishtha Adhikari devotee, neophyte devotee, he gives respect because principle of respect is the culture of devotional life. So a Kanishtha Adhikari Bhakta gives respect to the Supreme Lord and his spiritual master, nobody else. Two person, who? Krishna and my guru. Okay, two person. But when some devotee comes to the level of Madhyama Adhikari, he gives respect to all the devotees, all the Vaishnavas. And a Uttama Adhikari devotee gives respect to each and every living entity. So what is the symptom of advancement? When the area of respect expands. That is a symptom of advancement in Krishna consciousness. How we are able to expand the area of our respect. Kanishtha Adhikari, our respect is limited to Krishna and Guru. Madhyama Adhikari, it expands to all the Vaishnavas. And when Uttama Adhikari platform comes into our life, then it expands to all living entities. You understand? That is the symptom of advancement. But we think the symptom of advancement means how our area of receiving respect is increasing. More people are respecting means I am advancing. Previously, nobody used to respect. Now, people are slowly, slowly understanding my glories. So slowly, slowly, they are also changing and giving respect. And I am thinking, I am advancing in Krishna consciousness. This is the snare of Maya. Krishna is very expert to keep us in this material world. He gives the knowledge, but at the same time, Maya is very strong. And we fall in the trap of Maya. So therefore, Mahaprabhu is teaching us by his own example. Although he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead himself, but he is waiting for the order of his Guru to start his preaching mission. So our mood should be the same mood, following in the footsteps of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Whatever service we do, that should be approved by our authorities. That is the symptom of devotional service. And Nityananda Prabhu did the same thing. Nityananda Prabhu, he left Ekachakra Dham at the age of 12, then moved around all over India for 20 years. But he never preached Krishna consciousness. Never. He was in all the holy places of India. But there is no mention of Nityananda Prabhu preaching Krishna consciousness. Why? Because he is also following the footsteps of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is waiting when Mahaprabhu will start. As soon as he got the news that Mahaprabhu has started Sankirtan movement in Mayapur, he immediately reached Mayapur Dham. And when Mahaprabhu ordered Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur, Sona Sona Nityananda Sona Haridas, Sarvatra Amaragga Karo Prakash, Prati Ghare Ghare Gya Karoi Vikha, Balo Krishna, Bhaja Krishna, Karo Krishna Shiksha. When he got the order, Nityananda Prabhu also started the preaching mission. Krishna Balaram, they came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They are not starting their service of preaching until and unless they are ordered to do so. But we, insignificant spirit soul, 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair, we don't like to serve under the authority structure. That's why we'll be stuck in this material world only, even if we preach Krishna consciousness. So, Krishna consciousness preaching activity is dependent on our mood. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu is exhibiting what kind of mood we should have in our preaching. So that is the first point I wanted to make, that in order to preach, we have to be what? We have to serve under the authority. It's good news or bad news? Good news? I don't know, some faces are very not so happy faces. Accepting authorities is very, very important in our spiritual life. Otherwise, very difficult life we'll lead without authority in our life. So then, Mahaprabhu, after taking sannyas, Mahaprabhu took sannyas at the age of 24. Okay, anybody is here 24 years of age? Okay. Yes. And Mahaprabhu is very heavily criticized. Why? Why he took sannyas at the age of 24? Is it a right decision or wrong decision? What do you think? Mahaprabhu took a right decision to take sannyas at the age of 24? Huh? I'm asking the real answer, not philosophical answer. Real answer from your heart. Too young to take. That is the real answer. Philosophically, it is correct. Okay. So, too young. So, who is young? How many of you are young here? Young. Prabhu, we are all young. Who are you talking? It's not the place of old people. So when we ask age, what we ask? How old are you? We never ask, how young are you? So by this question we can understand we are all old. We say, I am 10 years old, I am 20 years old, I am 50 years old, everybody is old. We should be very thoughtful, no? Devotee means who thinks deeply. So what is old age? What is old age? Definition of old age. What? Anybody. So who is that anybody? So how many of you are vicinity to death? Tell me. Everybody. Oh, really? So highly realized soul sitting here. So by that, nobody is young. Everybody is old. But because we don't know when you are going to die. Especially in Kali Yuga. Especially in the city. Accidental death is very common. Other ages, there is no accidental death. There is no accident because there is no traffic. There is no motor vehicle. So life is very risky. Once you come, go out of the house, in a vehicle, no guarantee that you will come back. That is the nature of this world nowadays. So we are old. So according to Varnashram, people go to the forest when? At the age of 50. Why 50? That is half of the age. So the system is, we should go to the forest at the middle, when we reach the middle portion of our life, 50%. So why 50 is the middle? Because we are supposed to live for 100 years. That's why at the age of 50, we should go to the forest. Mahaprabhu lived for how many years? 48 years. So 24 is what? So he did. Rightly or wrongly? So that revelation came to me last month. I was also thinking, why 24? People ask so many questions, people criticize Mahaprabhu like that. So there are so many explanations, but this explanation came to my mind. Actually, Mahaprabhu took the decision exactly the way it should be taken. Because Mahaprabhu knew that he is going to live only for 48 years, because that is the duration of his earthly pastime. So, in order to render service to the people in general, he needs 24 years. That's why he took sannyas at the age of 24. Although, socially, it was not so appropriate. Because young wife was there. How old was she? When Mahaprabhu took sannyas, Vishnupriya Devi was 16 years old. And Mother Sochi was in her old age. So old mother, young wife, at the age of 24 sannyas is not a good combination, socially. But Mahaprabhu did that because Mahaprabhu wanted to help all of us. In order to help all the conditioned souls of this world, he took that pain of taking sannyas. That is the mood of a preacher. Preaching should happen out of compassion. Mahaprabhu took sannyas out of compassion for all the living entities of this world. So what is preaching? Preaching is an expression of compassion. But Kali Yuga is a Yuga of passion. We do preaching out of passion. But Mahaprabhu did preaching out of compassion. So our journey is to reach the level of compassion from passion. So journey is from passion to compassion. What is the meaning of compassion? English, you are speaking in English. What is the meaning of compassion? Feeling the pain of others. But I have a different definition. You want to hear that? Compassion means com. Com means less. Passion means passion. Passion reduces, compassion increases. So if you want to cultivate compassion, we have to reduce our passion. So we cannot be compassionate when we function at the level of mode of passion. So you have to cultivate at least mode of goodness. So who can be a preacher who is situated at the mode of goodness? He can be a preacher. So cultivating mode of goodness is very, very important in order to be a good preacher. Because preaching is done not based on passion, preaching is done based on compassion. Mahaprabhu did that. Expression of compassion is preaching. So Mahaprabhu preached to who? That is also another interesting point. Generally we focus, no? Mahaprabhu also focused. So Mahaprabhu preached to who? He preached to every living entity, every section. He preached to the intellectuals, scholars. He preached to the general public, right? He preached to the Mayavadi sannyasis. He preached to the animal kingdom also. Thieves, rogues, drunkard, everybody. He preached to everyone. So preaching means we should preach to every living entity. That is the mood of a preacher. It's not that our preaching should be only directed to some section. We should be focused. Because if we preach to the leaders of the society, then preaching impact is more. So Mahaprabhu, he started his preaching in Jagannath Puri. And who was the first person to be preached? Who is that? Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. He was not an ordinary person. He was a software engineer during that time. He was highly learned, big scholar. Even the Mayavadi sannyasis used to learn from him. Such a scholar he was, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Topmost scholar. So Mahaprabhu started his preaching mission with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. So he was not an ordinary scholar, he was very, very elevated scholar. So when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya saw Mahaprabhu, because Mahaprabhu entered into Jagannath temple and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya saw him. Then he saw that Mahaprabhu is young, only 24 years old. And he was very beautiful, handsome, beautiful looking, effulgent. 24 years old, beautiful looking. And main problem is that he is only singing and dancing, enjoying. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya became very concerned. Such a young man, how he can maintain his sannyas ashram of life? Compassionate. So he thought that I should help him by teaching him Vedanta. Because concept of sannyas life means we should be absorbed in Shastra. And Mayavadi sannyasis, they feel we can be a high class sannyasi when we are absorbed in studying Vedanta. But Mahaprabhu is not studying Vedanta at all. He's always singing and dancing like a sentimental person. So he thought I should train him up. And he also thought that he took sannyas from Bharati Sampradaya. Bharati Sampradaya is not high class. In their top class is other sampradayas, Saraswati and other. But he took sannyas from Keshav Bharati Maharaj. So Bharati Sampradaya is little second level. Just like engineering, IIT, then NIT. I think Bharati is NIT level, not IIT level. Okay? Second level. So he thought I should also upgrade him by my training. So he started the training program. 7 days training program. He started speaking Vedanta. 7 days, seven night. Continuous. Continuous hearing. Mahaprabhu was hearing and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was speaking. For how long? 7 days and seven nights. Can you do that? 45 minutes is difficult. Okay. So, but Mahaprabhu was listening very attentively. So, hearing is very, very important. Hearing. Whether you are a guru or whether you are a disciple. And for disciple is more important to hear. So, Mahaprabhu was hearing, continuously hearing, without any distraction. So, why hearing is important? Because hearing can awaken love of Godhead. Whatever we have inside in a dormant state. So, that dormant love of Godhead can be awakened by hearing. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhaka Punai Sravanadi Suddha Chitte Karo Udai. You are familiar with Chaitanya Charitamrita? No, not so much. You hear Bhagavatam more. Because I am from Mayapur. And I have been told to speak from Chaitanya Charitamrita by your leaders. Okay? So, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhya Kubu Nai Sravanadi Suddha Chitte Karo Udai. So, that love of Godhead has to be awakened by hearing. There is no other way. That's why Krishna has given, Lord has given 2 ears and one mouth. Very significant. I don't know how many of you are from medical background. We are all engineers here. Huh? Any medical background people are here? Only one. Two. Okay. 2 years. ENT specialist. No. 2 years, one mouth. So ears are always open. It's also significant. And mouth is supposed to be closed. But Kali Yuga is opposite. Right or wrong? Mouth is always open. We like to talk. And by the mercy of the mobile phone, and by the mercy of the scheme of unlimited talk time, and we have to spend for that, so we have to justify our spending, so therefore we always talk. No desire to hear. That shows the quality of people in this age. Quality of a person depends on how he can hear properly. Those who are very, very elevated person, they talk less, hear more. That is the symptom of an intelligent person. And those who are not that level, they like to talk. So disciple, what is the quality of a disciple? First quality of a disciple, that he is ready to hear. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, Prabhupada used to say that I always observed that Abhay is always hearing with rapt attention. Very good. He identified that he is hearing very attentively, and that's why Prabhupada became so successful. And he was asked, what is the secret of success of your preaching mission? He said, I know only one reason. Whatever I heard from my guru, I just repeated it as it is. That was my only qualification. So how you can repeat? If you hear, no? If nothing goes in, how it can come out? So hearing is very, very important. But when you come for hearing, problem begins. Very difficult to keep our eyes open during hearing. So that's why you should join Brahmachari Ashram. In ashram, there is a facility to sleep 9 hours. I am putting some advertisement for all of you. If you want to enjoy sleep for 9 hours, join ashram. 6 hours at night, 2 hours during japa and 1 hour during Bhagavatam class. So, facility is there. Every place has some advantage. So, we love to sleep. And especially during japa. People say, Prabhu, whatever experience of freshness we get by 6 hours, after sleeping during japa, we feel very fresh. So, somebody came to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, after doing meditation, I am feeling very fresh. Prabhupada said, yes, definitely you feel fresh because you had such a nice sleep. So meditation means sleeps. That's why our movement is not a movement of sleeping. Our movement is a movement of chanting and dancing. Sankirtan, japa means sleep. But you cannot sleep during Sankirtan on the street. That's why our movement is a movement on the street. All three preaching activities Prabhupada introduced, all are on the street. Food distribution or prasad distribution on the street, book distribution on the street, and Harinam Sankirtan on the street. So our movement is a movement on the street. That's why Prabhupada said, even if all our temples are closed, no problem. If book distribution continues, my movement will spread. I used to think, why Prabhupada said like that? There is a connection. What is the connection? And he said that if book distribution stops, my movement will stop. Why? There are so many scholars. Prabhupada said, ISKCON is my body. And BBT, Bhaktivedanta Book Trust, the publishing wing of ISKCON, BBT is my heart. And what is the purpose of heart? Pumping the blood, right? Doctors are here. Pumping the blood. But to pump the blood, you need blood, na? If there is no blood in the body, then how the heart will pump? If there is no blood in the body, then what will happen? Hare Krishna to the body. So, Popa said, money, ISKCON money is my blood. So, how heart can get money? Blood? Books. ISKCON purchases books from BBT. Right or wrong? And that money goes to BBT. So, by buying books, you are giving blood to the heart of ISKCON body. So if book distribution stops, then there will be no money going to BBT, means no blood is going to the heart, and in that way the whole society, the whole body will collapse. So therefore, book distribution has to continue. December month, some understanding of book distribution, philosophical understanding, according to the teachings of Prabhupada, very, very important. So coming back to the point of hearing, so who can repeat, who can hear? That's why sadhu sangha means what? Sadhu sangha means hearing. Arjuna, because it's the month of Bhagavad Gita also. So Arjuna was just next to Krishna. Just next to Krishna in the same chariot. But still Arjuna was bewildered. Staying next to Krishna is not important physically. You can stay next to your guru, you can stay next to your Vaishnava, you can stay next to your God, but you may be bewildered. So physical proximity is not important. Arjuna was just next to Krishna, still he was bewildered. But he came out from his bewilderment when he started hearing from Krishna. When he heard Bhagavad Gita, then he was free from all illusion and doubts. So in the same way, in the footsteps of Arjuna, if we want to be free from doubts, illusions, bewilderment, just staying next to a temple, just staying next to a sadhu, just staying next to your God is not enough. We have to hear. And Prabhupada used to say, hear attentively, keeping your eyes open. Sometimes people feel attentive means closing the eyes. That's true. But when the problem with closing eyes is that if you close, you never open. So better keep it open and hear attentively. Okay? But some people come and they sit at the front row. And as soon as lecture begins, he also begins. He sleep. And that's why I always say, if you want to sleep, no problem. Go to the back. But if you sleep at the front row, you can enjoy, but what happens? The speaker has problem. Because speaker will look at the person because he's thinking only, my God, I am suffering, he's enjoying life. So, better go back. But there is a man who used to come for hearing Krishna Katha, Hari Katha, every day. Some people are like that. They come for every day. That is a culture. Satsang, sadhusang, hearing, very important. So that person used to come and used to sit the very sincere at the front row. And as soon as the speaker starts speaking, he used to be in samadhi. Complete samadhi for the whole class. Class ends, his samadhi breaks and he goes. And it does not happen one day. Maybe we tired one day, it can happen. But not one day, 2 day, 1 week, every day. And he used to come for every day for long, long period. And the speaker was fed up. Fed up with that devotee, that person. So as soon as he used to come in, he heard, although he did not hear anything from the speaker, but he heard three sentences. The talk was in Hindi, because in Hindi speaking area, a lot of katha happens. So as soon as he used to enter into the room or hall, so when he enters, he used to, the speaker, as soon as he saw him, he used to ask a question, "Aa gaya kya?" First mantra. He learned how many mantras? Three mantras. First mantra was, "Aa gaya kya? You have come in." You know Hindi, right? Bangalore people know Hindi. Then he used to come and sit at the front row. "Baith gaya kya?" Second mantra. Then after that, no mantra was heard because he is in samadhi. So after he woke up, everybody is going, he is also going. And speaker used to chant the third mantra. "Ja raha hai kya?" So he heard these three mantras attentively every day. Abhi, kya kya? What was the three mantras? "Aa gaya kya?" Boliye. "Aa gaya kya? Baith gaya kya? Ja raha hai kya?" And when you hear mantra like this regularly, it sinks into your system. So when you are attached to something, you do that during your sleep also. Who loves to play cricket or football, they play during sleeping time also. And very dangerous to sleep next to him. So this man, because he was hearing so many times, he used to chant this mantra during his sleep also. When he was sleeping, he used to chant, "Aa gaya kya? Baith gaya kya? Ja raha hai kya?" During sleeping also. So one day, one thief came to his house. So he got the news that this guy is very rich guy and nobody stays in his house. So he thought this is the best place to steal. So he came midnight. He entered into the house. But he never knew that this guy speaks during sleeping also. So as soon as he entered, his mantra started, "Aa gaya kya?" So the thief thought he's sleeping in his room, but he cannot see me, but still he's talking to me. What's going on? He was a little scared. Then he sat down to hide himself. Then that man started saying, "Baith gaya kya?" I said, "My God, he can see so clearly." Then he became more scared and started going out. "So ja raha hai kya?" So he was completely convinced. Then he ran away from the house. So some benefit is always there, whether you sleep or awake. So when you sleep, so some advantage is there also when you sleep in your house. So the thieves, they run away. But that is not the real benefit of hearing. So real benefit of hearing is when our internal thieves, in the form of lust, anger, greed, pride, envy, illusion, they run away from our heart. Then that is the success. But in order to achieve that, we have to come to a different level of hearing. So it says that first level of hearing, you hear from this ear and goes out from other ear. Is kan se us kan, is kanam is kan. So nothing goes in. So it goes, comes from, goes through this ear and comes in through this ear and goes out from other ear. And they are very attentive also. Very good class. What you heard? That I don't know, but it was very good. Because nothing entered. But second level of hearing is, you hear from this ear. But why you are hearing? Because you want to speak. Copy-paste, no? So why you are hearing? Because you like to repeat it. Because he's such a nice speaker. If I can repeat it also, I can be a nice speaker also. So they hear from this ear and speaks from the mouth. Better than the iskan se uskan. But the real hearing, according to Srimad Bhagavatam, when you hear, it does not go out. Means it enters into a system and goes to the heart. So real hearing means when the sound vibration comes through the ear and enters into the heart of a listener. That is the real hearing. So Srimad Bhagavatam explains, when a pure devotee speaks, realized soul speaks, he does not speak from brain. He speaks from heart. It's not a presentation. In our preaching, we do presentation. Presentation cannot transform people's life. It gives information. But spiritual life means transformation. So why we take initiation? Not because of information. For that we have another guru, Google guru. So for information you don't need guru in your life. But for transformation we must have a guru. Because guru means who can transform our life. So transformation takes place within. That's why sound vibration has to come within. So when a realized soul, a pure devotee speaks, he speaks from the heart. Because he is realized. And that sound vibration carries the aroma of the dust of the lotus feet of Krishna. Because in the heart of a pure devotee, Krishna resides. So that sound vibration carries the aroma of the dust of the lotus feet of Krishna. And when that sound vibration enters into the ear of a sincere listener and goes to the heart, then Krishna is transferred from the heart of the speaker to the heart of the listener. And Prabhupada tells, this is known as Diksha. What is the meaning of initiation? When Krishna is transferred from the heart of the guru to the heart of the disciple. That is the process of initiation. And that is the real hearing. So Mahaprabhu was hearing attentively. But he was not asking any question. After 7 days and seven nights, no word from the mouth of Mahaprabhu. When the students don't speak anything, two things can happen. First possibility that he understood everything. And second possibility, he understood nothing. So, Sarvamo Bhattacharya was a little concerned that I am speaking for 7 days and seven nights. Nothing is coming out from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So whether he is understanding or not, let me check. So after 7 days and seven nights, Sarvamo Bhattacharya asked Mahaprabhu, did you understand what I spoke? So Mahaprabhu said, I understood the sloka, but I could not understand your explanation. What an insult to a teacher. Because Prabhupada wrote Bhaktivedanta purport to make us understand the text of Srimad Bhagavatam. No? If somebody says, yes, I understood the text of your book, but I could not understand your purport. So Mahaprabhu said like that. That I understood the verses as it is, very nicely I understood, but I could not understand your explanation. Why? Because your explanation was covering the real meaning of Vedanta Sutra. That's why I could not understand. Insult? Yeah, everybody understands from me. But he is telling that my explanation is covering the meaning. He was very angry, upset. Then it was requested that please explain Atmaram verse. There is a verse, Atmaram, Atmaramascha Munaya, in the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya started explaining that verse in 9 different ways. Beautiful explanation. Mahaprabhu was hearing. After his explanation was over, Mahaprabhu started his own explanation. And Mahaprabhu explained the same verse in 18 different ways without touching any explanation of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya woke up. He understood he is not a sannyasi. He is not a human being. He must be the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And he surrendered his life at the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But what quality Mahaprabhu exhibited as a preacher? Hearing. He was hearing. And that needs humility. We have to hear so many nonsense of this world. But we have to wait for the moment when we can speak. Krishna did the same thing. Right or wrong? Arjuna was speaking very intelligently. Right or wrong? Arjuna's speech in Bhagavad Gita was a good speech or not? I don't want to fight. Proposal of peace. I don't want fight. Better I should go to the forest and live by begging. Why? Because I don't want to see. What is the use of this kingdom? Because everybody will be killed. So better no fight. It's a good proposal or bad proposal? Tell honestly. Huh? It's a good proposal? Very good proposal. That's why people in general, they love Arjuna. And they don't like at all Krishna. Why? They think that Arjuna was such a nice man. Such a nice proposal he gave. But Krishna spoiled him by speaking Bhagavad Gita. That's why many people don't like to read Bhagavad Gita. Why? Before Bhagavad Gita, it was peaceful. After Bhagavad Gita, war. Kurukshetra war. So family people, they don't like war in the family. So they read whole Mahabharata except Bhagavad Gita. Because they don't want war, Kurukshetra war in their house. So now life is a choice. What you want? You want peace in the family or Krishna in your family? Think. They are really thinking now. So they answer, why not both, Prabhu? Krishna and peace both. That should be. But that's not the way spiritual life is. We cannot have everything. When Krishna was there in Dwaraka, both Arjuna and Duryodhana both went to Krishna for help. So Arjuna asked for help and he asked for Krishna. But Duryodhana asked for Narayana Sena. So now we also have a choice whether we want Krishna or Narayana Sena. But we always have an idea, why not both? But sometimes both cannot be available. If you have a choice, either Narayana Sena or Krishna, what you will choose? That is the test of Krishna consciousness. And everybody has to go through that test. You should not think only Arjuna went through that test. Everybody has to go through that test. When there is a choice to make, you want Krishna or peace? You want Krishna or Narayani Sena? What will you choose? What is the meaning of Narayani Sena? Material opulence. Peace means nice situation. So either we want nice situation, material opulence or Krishna. When that choice will come, what will you choose? Tell me. That is the test of Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness is not sometimes very palatable externally. So we have to go through the test. So coming back to the point of Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu was hearing, Krishna also was hearing. When Krishna started speaking, when Arjuna stopped speaking. So as a disciple, if you want to hear from Guru, then we should keep our mouth shut. That is the first austerity of a disciple. We talk about many austerity. The first austerity of a disciple is to keep our mouth shut in front of the spiritual master. That's why when Rup and Sanatan, Rupa Goswami and Sanatan Goswami came in front of Mahaprabhu, they put a straw in their mouth. And it is explained that putting straw in the mouth is the symptom of humility. So they put straw in the mouth. The question arises, what is the connection between humility and the straw in the mouth? Very important. If you put straw in the mouth, you cannot open your mouth. Because if you open your mouth, your straw will come out. So by putting the straw in the mouth, you are indicating that you are a disciple. I am not in a desire, or I am not having a desire to speak. I desire to hear from you. That's why I am keeping my mouth shut. And what is another meaning of keeping the straw in the mouth? Who eats straw? Animals. So by putting straw in the mouth, he is exhibiting that I am at the animal platform. I am an animal. So disciples should feel like that. That I am such an unqualified person. In front of the spiritual master, we should feel like that. Prabhupada used to say, in front of your guru, you should feel like a fool, but act most intelligently. That is the beauty of disciple life. So these are symptoms. So here, Mahaprabhu is exhibiting the quality of a preacher, that he is dealing with some intellectual person, but he is talking bogus. Still, he was hearing to give him respect. So giving respect is very, very important in order to be a successful preacher. And he did the same thing when he was with the sannyasis at Varanasi. Right? So when Mahaprabhu was in Varanasi, people used to criticize him. Who? The sannyasis. The criticism was that he's a sannyasi, he's supposed to study Vedanta, but instead of doing that, he is singing and dancing like a sentimental person. So when we are in this world, as long as we are in this world, there will be criticism. Even the Lord is not spared. So this is the world of criticism. Whatever you do, there will be criticism. You like to hear a story for that? So Lord Shiva is a Vaishnava. So Lord Shiva, along with his wife Parvati Devi, were going on the bull, their career. So when both of them were riding on the bull, people started criticizing. See, one bull, two men, two person, no feeling, no love. What is this? Criticized. So Shiva said, yeah, they are telling right. Then what he did? He put Parvati Devi on the bull and he was walking. And people could say, see, what a wife. Husband is walking, wife is enjoying. Then they exchanged. Then Lord Shiva was on the bull, Parvati was walking. Then people can see, what a husband. No shame. Wife is walking, he is enjoying bull. And said, it's too much. Then both of them came down, and both of them were walking, bull was also walking. Now that says, fool. They are not using the bull. So whatever you do in this world, there will be some criticism. So Mahaprabhu was criticized. But we feel very disturbed. As soon as some, why he spoke like that? Why he spoke like that? You cannot control the mouth of the people. There are so many mouths, no? Unlimited number of mouths. Try to control yourself. You cannot control others. That is the problem. We always think that how everybody should change. Except me. But we should start our journey by changing ourselves. That is called Krishna consciousness. But we always expect that everybody will change according to my way, but I don't want to change. So therefore, this kind of attitude is not good. And at the same time, you have to understand that criticism will be always there. Everybody will be criticized in this world. Because this world is the world of critics. So Mahaprabhu was disturbed. A pure soul is not disturbed by criticism. That is a symptom of pure devotee. I want to narrate one more first time. Okay, time is quickly. There is a brahmana, that is a very good pastime. This is related to Bhagavad Gita. Today, this month is the month of Bhagavad Gita. So that brahmana is from Srirangam, South India. He used to recite Bhagavad Gita every day, 18 chapters. But he was not a learned person, that's why he could not recite Bhagavad Gita properly. Improper pronunciation. But that time, Srirangam was the place of scholars. And they used to criticize, ridicule him, laugh at him. But he was completely undisturbed, happy. Abhishta hoya Gita pare anandita mana chaitanya chaitamita explains that man was not at all disturbed. Abhishta hoya Gita pare anandita mana. He was completely in joy. Anandita mana. Joyfully he was reading Bhagavad Gita. How? Because he was completely absorbed. Abhishta hoya. So absorption is very, very important. Krishna consciousness means absorption. Is nothing external. Absorption of the mind. When someone is absorbed in Krishna, he cannot be disturbed. So that brahmana was very happy. Why? Because he was absorbed. In the same way, we will not be disturbed also by criticism when we are absorbed in Krishna consciousness. Absorption gives satisfaction, happiness, bliss. So Krishna consciousness means absorption. So Mahaprabhu was not disturbed. At all disturbed. So, he was not caring so much, but his associates were disturbed. So when someone criticizes me, I should not be disturbed. But someone is criticizes others, I should be disturbed. We should not hear the criticism of others. And his devotees, his associates, Tapan Mishra, Chandrasekhar Acharya, all these people, they thought that is not good. That Mahaprabhu is criticized so much. So one brahmana, he organized a meeting. He organized a meeting with all the sannyasis of Varanasi in his house. So all the sannyasis came and Mahaprabhu also took the invitation from that brahmana, went there. So Mahaprabhu washed his feet before entering the place. That is the system. When you enter into the temple, we should wash our feet. Prabhupada is writing in the purport. Washing feet. Cleanliness is very, very important. So he entered and he was sitting the place where he washed his feet. And they are sitting, all the sannyasis are sitting in an elevated platform. And Mahaprabhu was sitting where he washed his feet. That is the way to melt the heart of people. When you take a humble position, even if your critics will change their heart. So when they saw that Mahaprabhu took such a stand of humility, so their heart melted and they came and brought Mahaprabhu to their places. And they asked the same question, what they used to criticize, they asked frankly in front of Mahaprabhu, that you are a sannyasi, you are from a Bharati Sampradaya, you are supposed to study Vedanta. Instead of associating with us, instead of studying Vedanta, you are chanting and dancing with the devotees. What is this? Why? Can you explain? So Mahaprabhu said, I have to be honest, because my guru told me that you are a fool. You don't have any authority to study Vedanta. So what can I do? So he gave me a mantra. And I don't know what kind of mantra he gave. Whenever I chant, I become mad. Kiba mantra dilagosai kiba tar bol, jopite jopite mantra korila pagal. So Mahaprabhu said that my guru gave me a mantra and whenever I chant, I become mad. So when you become mad, you don't know what you do. So whether I'm dancing or singing, I don't know what I'm doing, because as soon as I start chanting the mantra, I become mad. So that is the effect of Mahamantra. So Mahaprabhu is trying to establish the supremacy of Mahamantra. And the essence of all Vedic literature is chanting the holy name of the Lord. Srimad Bhagavatam also explains, at the end of Srimad Bhagavatam, the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam is chanting of the holy name. That's why it is said, Bhajaner Madhya Sestha Navavida Bhakti. Krishna Prem Krishna Dite Dhare Mahashakti. If all kinds of devotional services, the ninth process of devotional service as described by Prahlad Maharaj in Srimad Bhagavatam, Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Saranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasham, Shakham, Atma, Nivedanam, Iti, Pungsharpita, Vishnu, Bhaktistana, Valakshana. That ninth process of devotional service is topmost. Why? Because Krishna Prem, Krishna Dite, Dhare Mahasakti. It has a great potency. They have a great potency to give Krishna and love for Krishna. Tar madhye sarvashrestha nam sankirtan. Out of this nine, the topmost is nam sankirtan, chanting of the holy name. Why? Niraparadhena nam loile pai premadhan. If you chant the holy name of the Lord without any offense, you get love of God. So the same thing Mahaprabhu was teaching, or rather speaking to the sannyasis of Varanasi, and they accepted. And they started asking. Then he said that then Mahaprabhu started giving the secondary, that the meaning you give for Vedanta, you should not think that devotees don't know Vedanta. They know Vedanta. They are the most learned scholar of Vedanta, but they know the real meaning. So Mahaprabhu gave the secondary explanation of Vedanta, then he also gave the primary explanation of Vedanta, and all the sannyasis of Varanasi became Gauriya Vaishnava by the potency of Mahaprabhu's preaching. And how? What is the secret? Secret was not Mahaprabhu's scholarship. The secret is humility. That is the symptom of real knowledge. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane gavihastini suni chaiva sapakecha pandita samadarshina. Who is pandit? Who is intelligent? Who is intellectual? Who is humble? The symptom of an intelligent person is an humble person. But in our society, who is intelligent? Who has many degrees? B.Tech, M.Tech, Ph.D. So I like to crack a joke about education. You want to hear that? Because Prabhupada said that a devotee should feel like a fool in front of the spiritual master. That is the first qualification. Mahaprabhu also had the same mood. He said that my guru told me, I am a fool. So what is the qualification to be a disciple? To be a fool but act like most intelligent person. How it is possible? That is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. So when you are very intelligent, then you take up science and do B.Tech and M.Tech, right? Then if intelligence is not so that high, then you take up commerce, second level. Then you become MBAs. Then if you cannot do that, then you take up arts and you go for civil service exams. Then if you cannot do that, you do homeschooling and you become political leaders. And if you cannot do that also, you become sadhus. that is not the end. So M.Tech and B.Tech, they work under the MBAs. Right? MBAs work under the IS officers. And IS officers work under the political leaders. And political leaders take shelter of the sadhus. So what happens to the B.Tech and M.Tech? Very sad, but that is the reality of life. So degree is very important, but degree is not the real factor in life. But somehow in India, we feel that degree is most important. So a man said, a successful company owner, he said, I used to fail in my school. And my friend used to be the topper. And that friend of mine is working in my company now. So I am not against degree, but degree is not everything in life. But we feel like that. Intelligence is more important than degrees. Einstein used to say, what is the greatest obstacle in my learning? The greatest obstacle between me and learning is my education. The car number KA1096 is blocking the road. Please change your location of the car. Okay, so I should, 9:45, so I can give an analysis of car. So to end the program today. So the point to be noted is that we should not be so enamored by the degrees, because degree does not matter in life. The real knowledge, real intelligence is that intelligence which makes you humble. Vidya vinaya sampanna. So therefore, the life is life of problems. Prabhupada mentions in the purport of his books that this world is world of problems. We think that by changing our life in a different way, our problems will be not there. But that is not the case. If you solve one problem, there will be another problem. If you solve that problem, there will be another problem. What is the greatest problem? The real problem? The real problem when you think there will be a life without problem. That is the real problem. We always think like that. We have so many problems. Chant Hare Krishna, no problem. When we see after chanting, more problems. Then we become more confused. So you should not think like that. Krishna consciousness means no problem in life. But you have to know that Krishna consciousness means you can handle the problems. That is the difference. Those who are not having that Krishna consciousness, they become very depressed when problem comes. But when person is a Krishna conscious person, when problem comes, they see those problems as an opportunity to surrender more and more to Krishna. But we become very much disturbed by problems in life. So therefore, we should ride in a car. It's called transcendental car. And somebody gave the name Prabhupada's car. And when you have that car, then no problem. Your life will be very smooth without the traffic jam of Bangalore. That car does not face any traffic jam. What is that car? So she means change the changeable. Life is called life lesson. She means change the changeable. Which you can change, change it. A means accept the unchangeable. There are many things in our life which cannot be changed. But we get disturbed by that. But we have to accept it. So accept the unchangeable. And R means rise above the unchangeable. So if you have that car, then smooth journey to the spiritual world. Change the changeable, accept the unchangeable, and rise above the unchangeable. And that is the transcendental car. And in order to attain the lotus feet of Krishna, that car is very, very important. Rather, the lotus feet of Krishna is that car. When you enter into that car, then our journey of our spiritual life becomes very, very smooth without any disturbances from this material world. And that will be our success. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Bhagavad Gita ki, Srila Prabhupada book distribution ki, Gaur Premanande, Hare Hare Bo.